The order of a differential equation is the order of the highest order derivative that appears in the equation. Notation, we use f of t, y prime, y double prime, up to the nth derivative of y to represent an expression that involves the independent variable t and the dependent variable y along with its derivatives y double prime up to the nth derivative of y. Notice it is implied here that y is a function of t. So y prime is dy over t, etc. So a first order differential equation, y prime equals f of ty, so it's a function of t and y. Second order, the second derivative of y is a function of t, y, and y prime. Third order, y triple prime equals f of t, y prime, and y double prime. What is the order of the differential equation? Y double prime minus y prime minus 2y equals 2t plus 1. Well, the highest order derivative that appears here is the second derivative. So the order is second order. We also talk about linear versus nonlinear differential equations. Consider the differential equation, the nth derivative of y equals f of t, y double prime, all the way up to the n minus 1th derivative of y. If the equation is linear and the variables y prime, y double prime, all the way up to the nth derivative of y, then we say the differential equation is linear. So for example, looking at this differential equation, we have a second derivative, we have a first derivative, we have the function y. So this is going to be second order. And in all of our variables y, all the way up to the nth derivative of y, they are linear. So this differential equation is linear. Looking at this equation, this is the first derivative of y cubed equals y plus t. So notice the difference between this notation here and this. So this notation means the second derivative, where this notation means the first derivative cubed. So here, this is a nonlinear differential equation because of this cubed, and it is first order. Looking at this example, we have y, we have sine of y, and the third derivative of y. So this is going to be third order because of this third derivative. However, it is nonlinear because we have sine of y. In this example, y prime equals y times y minus 1. We have the y prime, so that's first order. And then we have y times y. So that's going to give us a y squared, which is not linear, so this is nonlinear.